الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise due to Allah and His praise and blessings and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, his family, his companions and his followers until the day of judgment, and all the prophets and the messengers and their followers. My dear brothers and sisters, today I will talk about a very sensitive topic for some people. It's about in-laws. And I call this episode in-laws or outlaws, because there is such reputation for in-laws. And I was always wondering, why is this bad negative reputation for in-laws? And guess what? It's not only related to one culture or related to even one religion. It's a very common, almost in every culture I visited in the world, from the Far East all the way to the West, to Middle East and Africa, Asia, you name it, Europe and America, South America. There's always bad reputation for in-laws. That's why I ask myself, is it really there is a problem with in-laws? Is it reality or just exaggeration? Even though I start Googling it, in-laws, what's it going to get first? A positive things or negative? I remember one of the links that I saw, what you should do if you miss your mother-in-law. So I said, maybe this is a good link. When I click on it, I got, after the link says, what you should do if you miss your mother-in-law. Then I found, when I went to that link, it says, reload and try again. Unfortunately. So I said to myself, this is so negative. This is so bad. You know, Alhamdulillah, I never had this problem as a person. And in a lot of people, a lot of friends, a lot of relatives, they don't have this problem with mother-in-law or father-in-law. But a lot of sisters call and complain. A lot of brothers complain that they having a hardship with their in-laws. As I said, it's not only related to one culture or to one religion. To the extent one of the books of the fiqh said, the quality of a good wife, when you look for a wife, what kind of quality you should look for. After they mention all the famous qualities, they said, and she should be a woman who has no mother. She is a one who has no mother. This is terrible. And I think this is not right at all. And I disagree with putting it like this, that mother-in-law or father-in-law are evil, because I think they are parents. They just love their parents. Today, I would like to discuss this issue and give maybe some practical solutions if you are facing a hardship with your in-laws. What are the common reasons for these problems to happen? What are the common reasons for these problems to happen? One, the wrong type of love and jealousy that the parents has towards their daughter-in-law or son-in-law. What I mean by that? So many parents, when their daughter or their son get married, they start feeling jealous. So the mother will feel that her son, he doesn't love her anymore, and he loves his wife more. Or she will feel that her daughter, she doesn't care about her anymore. All what she cares about her husband, this new life that she or he got. So the parents will start get angry, and they will start getting jealous, and they will start interfering in their son or their daughter's life, and the problems starts. We have to understand that love is not one kind. There is different categories of love. There is different types of love. Love is not one thing. The way I love my wife is totally different than the way I love my friends. The way I love my parents is totally different than the way I love certain type of food or certain type of drinks. For example, I love to drink coffee. My mother never felt jealous that I love coffee. She didn't feel that she was threatened by that love. You might love your friends. You love your friends. But the feeling, that type of love that you have towards your friends, towards, for example, a pet maybe that you have at home or the car that you drive, is totally different than the type of love that you have towards your wife. The same. The way I love Allah, the way I love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his messenger, the way I love the religion, it's different than the kind of love or the type of love that I have in my heart towards my wife or towards my kids. It's totally different type of love. If this been said, we have to understand that the way your son or your daughter love his or her spouse is totally different than the way he loves you as a parent. So don't be ever feel threatened by that love which is given from your daughter or your son to their spouse. Because this will not contradict that the love that they have in their heart towards you. If this can be understood, I think a lot of problem can be eliminated in early time. So always remember that the way that your son loves you, the way your daughter loves you, it is different than the type of love that they have towards their spouses. One also of the main reasons, I believe, for these problems to happen, that so many parents, they don't understand the new stage of life that their children are in right now. They still think that their children are the same one that they used to live at their homes before they get married. No, you have to understand that your son or your daughter, after they get married, they get into another stage of life. You cannot treat your children all the time in the same way. When he or she is a teenager, or when they became adult, and they became married, and they became father and mothers, you cannot treat them the same. Maybe you still look at them the same, but you know what? They have moved to another stage of life, and smart parents would understand this and will adjust themselves with that. This is a very important point. Understand that you cannot interfere with everything in your daughter's or your son's life anymore. That they have their life, they have also their privacy, they have their own time, you have to give them their space, basically. And understanding this will help you a lot to avoid problems with your daughter-in-law or your son-in-law. Also, I think one of the reasons for these problems to happen, which is from the children's side this time, that because so many brothers and sisters, after they get married, they don't fulfill their parents' rights. Basically, he or she, they got married, and all of a sudden, they got so busy in marriage, in this marriage life, and they don't contact their parents anymore. They don't basically call them or visit them or support them as they used to be. They don't show the compassion and the love that they used to show them when they were living with them. So what happened? The father and the mother, because they love their children so much, they will not think negatively about their children. What they will do, they will think that the reason for that, his wife. The reason for that, his or her husband. Then they will accuse the husband or the wife for this. And so many times, it's not true. The problems, it is from the son himself or the daughter. Also, one of the reasons for these problems to happen, that the marriage will happen without the knowledge or the approval of the parents. And when this happens, don't expect that they will be just fine and cool with it. No, they will not. They will always have this in their heart against this man or this woman. They will always feel that they were not consulted, that they were left out, that they did not share their son or their daughter the most important moment in their life, which is the moment of their marriage. So many problems happen because the parents were not consulted, or they don't know, or they don't approve this marriage in the beginning. So after marriage, they will still carry this in their heart, and they will cause problems to their children. Also, if the parents, they already have certain image for their son-in-law, if they already have perceptions, certain perception about their son-in-law or their daughter-in-law, if they have this already programmed in their mind, they will understand every action that you do in a negative way. I think these are the main reason for these problems to happen in the marriage life of the children. And inshallah, when we come back after the break, we will talk about some important tips to avoid these problems. Welcome back. After we talked about the common reasons for problems to happen or to cause by father-in-law and mother-in-law, we'll talk about some important tips to avoid problems with in-laws. One, this will be directed to the husband and to the wife. Always remember that your father-in-law and your mother-in-law are the parents of your spouse. Remember that. So many times the wife, she doesn't realize that this is his father and his mother. And so many times the husband does not realize that, you know what, this is your wife's parents. They are so dear to her. They are so dear to him. This is my father. This is my mother. This is the one that I know since I came to this life, before even I know my wife or I know my husband. Sometimes the husband will ask his wife to treat his parents or to look at them the same way he feels towards them. That's absolutely wrong. It will never happen. You're mistaken. So make sure that you understand this, because they have rights over their daughter. They have rights over their son. Don't forget that. Two, try to understand the culture and the personality of your in-laws. If you married to somebody from a different culture, let's say somebody from Africa married to somebody from Europe, or somebody from the Middle East married to a sister from India, for example. That's two different cultures. Make sure that you understand their culture. Make sure that you understand your father-in-law and your mother-in-law's culture, and you understand their personality, so you know how to deal with them. Because sometimes we say things in certain culture, does not mean any harm, but in other culture it could be very insulting. So these things will help you to have better relationship with your in-laws, to know what they're expecting from their daughter-in-laws. Do you know what they're expecting from their son-in-law? This will help you a lot to come closer to your in-laws. Three, understanding each party's limit from the beginning. And this is very important, that you set this limit from the beginning. For instance, I'm responsible. I'm in charge of raising my children. I don't want my children to watch movies, for example, which has bad scene. Your children go to your parents or her parents' house where they put the TV, and maybe there is not suitable movies on the TV. And you don't want your children to see such things. There are certain games you don't want your children to have because you think they are not good for them. So make sure that you tell them, when it comes to my children, when it comes to my son and my daughter, please make sure that my view or my why and my orders will not be broken, or my rules will not be broken. Talk about it openly from the beginning, so each party know their limits. Also, one of the tips will help you. Don't live with your in-laws in the same house as much as you can. This is very important, to have your own private place. Every woman and every man would like to be independent. So make sure that you understand this, you understand the need for this, and you try that, unless your father or your mother need you, unless her father or her mother need her and they are sick or nobody else taking care of them. This is a special case. But in general, try to have your own house next to them if this is possible. Also, one of the tips, try to design the role that you want for your in-laws to play in your children's life or in your life in general. Keep them busy before they keep you busy. What I'm trying to say here, make sure that you design for them the role that you want them to play, as I said, in your children's life. For example, you tell the grandparents, I want you to be in charge of teaching my kids the Salat, or the Quran, or the Surah. I want you to play this role in my life. Because don't expect your in-laws will just forget about you totally and your children. No, they would love to have a role in your life. So make sure that you design this for them. Consult them, but don't complain to them. There is a big difference between consulting them and complaining to them. If your husband giving you a hard time, and you go to your mother-in-law and your father-in-law, and you start complaining, and also the husband did the same thing with his parents, what's going to happen? The parents will take immediately a negative position against your spouse. And it's sometimes very hard for them to change that. While when you come back home and you meet your spouse and you can solve the whole entire problems and you are okay with her or she's okay with you, but you guess what? The damage that you have made at your parents' house is still there. That negative impression that they have about your husband or your wife is still there, settled in their mind. So don't complain to them, consult them. And there is a big difference between these two things. Also, give them gifts. Gift has a magic touch. It has a very powerful power impact on people's. So give them gifts and Eid in happy occasions. Make sure that you visit them, but don't visit too much, because in general, visiting somebody too much, it will cause that the person will be bored by this visitation. So visit them often, but not too often. Also, don't involve your in-laws in the details of your life. Give them a general picture, but the detail, the smallest details in your life, it might be a good idea if you see that there is a problem happening between you and your in-laws to keep the small details for yourself and inside your house, and not to share it with anybody unless there is a need for it. Be a good wife. Be a good husband. So nobody will have a chance to criticize you. So they will not have anything to say against you. And as much as we became a good husband and a good wife, and we keep a good relationship with each other, we love one another, we are a very happy family, as much as the parents will be happy. Because believe me, my brothers and sisters, the last things any parents would like to see their daughter or their son living in misery. Every father and every mother would love to see their children happy in their life. Also, be just and fair. Be just and fair. And be forgiving. Because they might do something to you you don't like. Or maybe your mother-in-law said something bothered you. Maybe your father-in-law did something and it was not nice to you. But you know what? Forgive them. And know that no matter what happened, they're still the parents of my husband. They're still the parents of my wife. And they deserve to be forgiven and deserve to be loved, because they are the one who brought this man to my life, or they are the one who brought this woman to my life. Also, my brother, sister, be fair and just. Some people, not just at all when they deal with their parents, with their father-in-law or mother-in-law. And as I said, as you all know, that justice is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us to have. And injustice is an act, it's a sin, and it's actually a major sin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made injustice forbidden. And finally, I would like to say, let small things go. You know, it's very important not to pick on every single word your mother-in-law say, or your father-in-law say. Just let small things go. And that will help you a lot, will help you a lot in eliminating so many problems with your in-laws. In the end, I have a word of advice for every father-in-law and mother-in-law. One, give your children a chance to gain their own experience in life. Trust them. Don't be mad or angry if your advice was not taken or implemented. You just advise them, and don't be mad or angry at all if they don't take your advice. So basically what you need to do, you give them the chance to develop their own experience. This is the nature of every human being. Maybe you were like that when you just get married. Also, advise rather than ordering. And discuss rather than threat. Don't threat them. Don't threat your daughter. Don't threat your son. Don't always say, you know what, I don't know you, and I don't want to talk to you. I'm angry at you. I'm mad at you. Allah will take you to the hellfire. Don't ever talk to me again. And don't come ever to my house again. This is not the way to deal with your children. This is not the way to make your point at all. Discuss whatever you have with your daughter or with your son. Advise them, but don't give them orders, because this is the way you should treat your children when they grow up and they became adult. Be confident in your children's love. Be confident in your children's love. Make always remember that your children love you so much. And that new element in their life, which is the husband or the wife, it doesn't mean that they lost their love towards you. No, they still love you so much. But maybe they are busy with their new life, with their children, with their spouse. So don't be threatened by that. Don't be scared. Don't let fear drive you. Make sure that you always have this confidence in your heart towards your children. Don't involve yourself in the details of your children's life. Don't involve yourself in the details of your children's life. Always remember that every generation, they have their own style of life. They have their own way of communication. And it does not necessarily to be the same way you communicate with your spouse. For example, in so many places, old generation, they used to communicate in certain ways, father and mothers. But young generations, it's different. But sometimes from one culture to another. Maybe your son or your daughter develop a new culture, not necessarily to be the same culture that you're living, especially if you're living in a different country. For example, somebody moved to America, moved to Europe. Their children usually develop a new culture. So don't expect your son or your daughter and your son-in-law and your daughter-in-law to deal and to communicate with the same way that you communicate with your wife or with your husband. So many times I hear parents said, oh, you know, when I get married to your father, I used to do this and that. You know, when we were young, we used, yes, because this is your generation. This is at your time, but not necessarily today. Today, life is different and people develop different culture. So make sure that you understand that. And again, to give them a chance to gain their own experience in life. Remember that you are not in a competition with your son-in-law or your daughter-in-law. Don't feel that way. Don't feel that you are in a competition with your daughter's husband or with your husband's wife. Who's going to take over the heart of my son or my daughter? No, it's not a competition. You know, you complete one another. You are a big family. This is the spirit that it should be in the house. This is the way that you should look to your son-in-law and to your daughter-in-law. And finally, to all my brothers and sisters, to all father-in-laws and mother-in-laws, remember to be always an element of success in your children's life. Don't be a source of stress or trouble to your children. Be always an element of success, a positive things in their life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring happiness and to success to all Muslims' family and to all families in the world. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.
I am a Muslim.